People are coming off the sidelines, getting back to their workplaces. Job satisfaction is higher than it's been in 36 years. We've seen record lows in unemployment for African Americans, Hispanic workers and veterans, and workers without high school diplomas, and the lowest unemployment rate in 70 years for America's women. At the same time, inflation continues to fall. It's now around 3%, about one-third of what it was 1 year ago. In fact, we learned yesterday that over the past three months, inflation was close to what it was before the pandemic. And incomes are higher now than they were before the pandemic. While pay for low-wage workers has grown at the fastest pace for low-wage workers in two decades. Remember, some experts said to get inflation under control, we needed higher unemployment and lower wages. But I've never thought that was the problem. Too many people having a job, or that working people were making too much money. And now, after months and months of bringing inflation down, while at the same time adding jobs and growing wages, it matters. And it's no accident. I came to office determined to build the economy in a different way, from the middle out and the bottom up, not the top down, to move away from trickle-down economics and instead focus on the middle class. Because when the middle class does well, and this is not hyperbole, when the middle class does well, everyone does well. Everyone does well. The wealthy do very well, the poor have a shot, and the middle class can make a living. The Financial Times and the Wall Street Journal have heard me say it before, started calling my plan Bidenomics. It's about investing in America and investing in Americans. It's working. A key pillar of Bidenomics is empowering and educating workers who are the backbone of this country. I want to mention a few actions my administration took this week to support workers by raising workers' pay and helping more workers get good-paying union jobs. First, we proposed a new rule to extend overtime pay for up to 3.6 million workers across the country, additional 3.6 million. And here's why that matters. Until now, salary workers who were not paid by the hour were often not guaranteed overtime pay unless they made less than $36,568 a year. That was a threshold. If you were a fast food manager or made even $1 more in salary, you were not guaranteed overtime pay, even if you worked an additional 40-hour week. The new rules we proposed this week, raised that threshold to $55,000 a year. That means a mom in North Carolina who makes $37,500 a year as an executive assistant and sometimes works a 60-hour work week, could now be guaranteed time and a half whenever she works over 40 hours in that week. Plus, moving forward, that salary threshold automatically will update every 3 years so that it stays up to date with wage growth and purchasing power. What would make it easier for workers to earn overtime in the future, it would. The automatic update was something we did in the Obama-Biden administration. My predecessor scrapped it. We've worked to bring it back, and it'll make a big difference for a lot of American families. Next, thanks to the Inflation Reduction Act, which I might add not a single member of the other party voted for, we're making the most significant investment in clean energy and combating the existential threat of climate change that's ever been made anywhere in the world. According to outside experts, the Inflation Reduction Act is projected to create more than 1.5 million jobs over the next decade, which I said when I was writing the legislation. This week, the Department of Treasury and the IRS announced guidance on new tax incentives for companies that invest in clean energy, like building wind turbines and installing solar power. In the previous administration, companies got a tax cut, and they could go wherever they wanted to, including overseas, and hire whoever they wanted in order to get that tax cut. But on my watch, we used tax cuts for companies to stay in America and create American jobs in America. We're providing additional tax incentive for companies to pay their workers prevailing wages, wages you can raise a family on. And if you get — and if they hire registered apprentices, like those trained and sponsored by unions, that's what happens. For some clean energy projects, they'll still be worth millions of dollars. This is a major incentive to pay prevailing wage and hire union workers. It's good for workers. It's good for the environment. And as companies are beginning to figure out, it's good for companies' bottom line as well. Plus, many auto companies significantly ramped up their investments in electric vehicles. My administration has announced more than $15 billion in funding to help automakers convert existing auto plants while retaining existing workers at good wages, giving them a first crack at the new and different jobs for electric vehicle versus the combustion engine, bolstering the domestic supply chain, and ensuring that auto manufacturing jobs remain good-paying jobs, including union jobs. The auto industry has long been a pathway to the middle class and had provided good-paying jobs. I'm not going to let that change in my watch if I can help it. And if anyone wonders whether unions really make a difference, I urge them to take a look at the new report from the Treasury Department. It's the most comprehensive look ever at the impact unions have on our economy. And it concludes definitively that unions raise workers' incomes, increase home ownership, increase retirement savings, increase access to critical benefits like sick leave and childcare, and reduce inequality, all of which strengthen the American economy. Plus, even workers who aren't in unions, even workers who have been laid off, see benefits from unions when they're strong, because unions raise standards across the workforce and industries, pushing up wages and strengthening benefits for everyone. You heard me say many times, Wall Street didn't build America. The middle class built America, and unions built the middle class. Let me close with this. We faced some pretty tough times in recent years, a pandemic that took more than a million of our friends and neighbors, a million fewer people sitting at our dining room or kitchen tables, people we raised and loved, people we grew up with, gone. The worst economic crisis since the Great Depression. It wasn't that long ago that 20 million Americans were out of work. But the American people didn't give up. They never give up. They've never given up. And today, we have the strongest economy in the world, the lowest inflation rate among the major economies, 13.5 million new jobs. You heard me say it before, and I'm going to keep saying it. My dad said a job's about a lot more than a paycheck. It's about your dignity. It's about respect. It's about being able to look your kid in the eye and say, honey, it's going to be okay, and mean it. That dignity is coming back to places all across the country. While I'm proud of the historic legislation my administration has passed and the policies we've enacted, the real heroes in this story are the American people, average Americans. They're the ones getting up every day, putting their heads down, going out that door and going to work. They're the ones starting new businesses, taking the chances, hiring workers, and fulfilling their dreams. 3 weeks ago, at a clean energy factory in Milwaukee, Wisconsin, I met an IBEW electrician who builds and repairs America's growing fleet of wind turbine engines. He said, and I quote, "In America, with hard work and a little faith, anything is possible. In America, with hard work and a little faith, anything is possible." That's what my father's generation believed. That's what these folks believe, too. every day across this country, ordinary people get up and do extraordinary things. Thanks to them, we're going to continue to grow our economy from the middle out, the bottom up, with good paying jobs, more breathing room for families and American workers, building industries of the future. They remind us of who we are. I'm going to keep saying this. We're the United States of America. There is simply nothing beyond our capacity when we set our mind to it and do it together. Have a good Labor Day weekend, and God bless you all.
Why are so many Americans living paycheck to paycheck?
Sir, I didn't interact with so many of your sons' business partners.